Hallo, assalamu alaikum, good morning, khush aamdeed, ji aaya nu, khuyamorakh.
Bakhair aagale, ni hao, chune shumme, washmale, ohaya gonzaimus, guten morgen, hola, bonjour, priviet, kaifahal, hale shumma chatore, alan wasalan, marhaba, buna, mucho, gracias, ishpata, and a very amazing good morning to everybody who's tuned into PTV World and are watching World this morning alongside the very dazzling, the very fashionable, the very modern, the very stunning, the very pretty, Shiza Hashmi. Hi, Shiza. How are you today?
I am now absolutely doing great. How are you doing?
I'm doing great too as well. I think I like the energy in me today as well. And it's just because of the fact that I actually got a chance to sleep very well last night.
Wow. And I think that's the key.
Yeah, and I think it is very imperative for good health too as well. For all those people who think that, you know, sleeping is, you know, you can sleep whenever you want. It's not like that. Ladies and gentlemen, there's a discipline. Nature actually runs in a discipline.
Definitely.
So the way your bodies have been formed or have been created, I think that, you know, 8 hours sleep is definitely important to look like us and be full of energy.
Well, that's a great point to start the day with. But, you know, I think the sleep worked for you. But today, Friday is working for me because the vibe and the aura of this day specifically is entirely different than any other day.
It is.
Well, there are two reasons, of course, I feel like. There's the religious factor as well. Of course, you feel blessed. You feel like sharing your prayers with everyone.
I know the second one.
The second
that is going to be the weekend.
It's going to be the weekend, you know, absolutely. And it's the half day, so you're definitely looking forward to something that is less stressful probably as compared to the other days of the week.
Exactly.
So we love Friday.
And I think that, you know, for example, ladies and gentlemen, Friday to me is like Choti Eid, you know, and it's because of the fact that, you know, you look forward to Friday probably every other day when you wake up in the throughout the week as well. And, you know, on Fridays, you know that you'll be wearing shalwar kameez,
right.
You're going to get dressed up. But other than that, ladies and gentlemen, Friday holds a very important place within our own religion as
Definitely.
Well. As Abu Huraira actually quoted Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam speaking about Friday, and he said that Friday is one of those best days when, you know, the sun was actually risen, and then Adam was created on Friday. Adam was actually entered into heaven on Friday and expelled from heaven on Friday as well. And then the day of judgment will be on Friday too as well. And,
you know, and
then at the same time, ladies and gentlemen, you know, when we talk about our, you know, religious affairs, I think that, you know, for a person who actually goes for the Friday prayer, you know, till the next Friday, I think that all of his sins are actually washed away.
Wow,
as well.
That's absolutely true, and that's great as well. So for all of you out there, I really hope you do, you know, offer your Friday prayers.
Yeah.
And if you do, I hope you do, please remember us in your prayers because we will remember you as well.
And we definitely need your prayers too, ladies and gentlemen. But time to rise and shine, wake and bake. But first, let's check whether are you going to get wet or cold when you're going to go outside.
Weather updates from around the country on
let's
your screens.
It.
So to begin with, widespread rain occurs in most parts of the country with heavy snowfall over the hills. And the Met Office has predicted that spell of rain is expected to continue during the next 24 hours. Dorvis Resort Murray has received more than a foot of snow. Wow. Imagine all the people who went there to actually enjoy their vacation as well. That is quite a lot of snow.
All right. And then according to latest reports, ladies and gentlemen, traffic police in Murray have made elaborate arrangements for the facilitation of tourists and smooth flow of traffic due to heavy snowfall in the area. Additional police personnel have been deployed to assist in traffic flow. The motorists have been advised to drive carefully due to slippery roads. The motorists should also use the chains for road grip.
And please, for all of you who are probably traveling to the north or Galiath or Murray side, make sure you reach out to the helpline as well, where you can actually see if the road conditions are good or favorable enough to travel.
Exactly. But, you know, I believe that, you know, it's not that time of the year, ladies and gentlemen, that you should actually be traveling to the north because a lot of roads are blocked. So please make sure that you call the right authority and check on that as well. And it is very important. But other than that, ladies and gentlemen, now, you know, there's this one thing which I'm very proud of, and thank you to our Premier, Mr. Imran Khan, as well, that, you know, he's been taking initiatives in a positive direction and in a, and in such a manner where nobody can actually demoralize the type of work he wants to do. And I think that it's going to turn out to be very beneficial.
Yeah,
now, for
indeed.
Example, I'm going to take you a little back, and it's because of the fact that we all know as Pakistanis, the dams are very essential for us now as well. And then there's this dam fund, which is actually being, you can go and deposit it into your banks. But other than that, There are these certificates which have been launched yesterday, ladies and gentlemen. There was a ceremony and it's for overseas Pakistanis. And they start from $5,000 and moving on as well. But now I think that this is one of those schemes where for overseas Pakistanis, they'll be so relaxed to actually know that their money will be so secure that whenever they're going to go and, you know, return the certificate and get the money back as well. So I think that a lot of overseas Pakistanis would love this initiative and will be buying all of these certificates.
Definitely.
Probably, you know, when I'm going to go abroad, I'll buy one for myself too as well.
Wow, that's great to hear. Because, you know, that is what all of them were looking for, of course, to invest in Pakistan because it is the homeland, but to have a conducive environment where everything is going to be safe. So, of course, this is the chance that the incumbent government
is
providing.
So before we introduce our very amazing guest, ladies and gentlemen, over here in the studios, we have this story to share with you guys. Go ahead, let's take a look at this one first, and then when you guys will come back, we'll actually introduce our guest, because Pakistan is definitely moving in the right direction.
Right.
Let's do that. So ladies and gentlemen, the government has launched the Pakistan Banao Certificate for the overseas Pakistanis. Addressing Pakistan Banao Certificate launch ceremony in Islamabad, Prime Minister Imran Khan appealed to overseas Pakistanis to purchase the certificates. The Prime Minister said the government is making concerted efforts to boost tourism in the country. He said Pakistan is blessed with numerous historic and scenic sites which are being opened for the international tourists to generate revenues. The Prime Minister pointed out that the country is facing the worst debt crisis of its history, which we all know by far. He said the government efforts to go to the friendly countries instead of opting for International Monetary Fund to tackle the debt crisis have yielded positive results. Wow. So ladies and gentlemen, let's getting started with the good news. And I think that, you know, probably all the overseas Pakistanis are out there. They definitely want to help in this dire time of need too, as well. And we'll definitely be able to generate $5-6 billion, if not less than that.
Fingers crossed.
Yeah. And to talk about this, ladies and gentlemen, this gentleman is definitely very close to our hearts.
Yeah.
He's been very regular on our show too, as well. He's one of those people who've actually brought Lithuania closer to Pakistan and Pakistan closer to Lithuania. He is Mr. Masood Khan, who is the Honorary Consul General of Lithuania. Hello, sir. Assalamu alaikum. Good morning.
Thank you very much. Thanks for inviting me.
Our pleasure.
Thank you very much for
always
joining us, and it's wonderful to have you over here.
No, thank you so very much.
But let's get it, let's get the conversation started. You've seen the report. You were there at the ceremony. Yeah. What is happening, and why is it happening, and why is it necessary that we actually have to trade in certificates now?
Actually, you know, it is, I being an overseas Pakistani, lived for 40 years abroad, and I have been on the board of OPF for couple of years. We have been suggesting this to the government right from the beginning, that instead of going it to IMF or borrowing the money from World Bank or other institution, I think this 9-10 million Pakistani living abroad, a lot of them has extra money to spare for in the name of Pakistan.
Yeah.
Right.
And give them little incentive and let's float this bond. And I'm very happy that yesterday Prime Minister and Asad Umar have announced that, and now this certificate is announced only for
overseas
Pakistanis. And usually whenever they launch the Sukuk, you know, they are restricted to buy minimum $200,000.
Okay.
Every Pakistani cannot buy that.
Yeah.
Right,
so we said that reduce it to $5,000 or $10,000 so Pakistani can buy it. And so a lot of Pakistani can invest in it. And as you rightly said, Shahzad, I'm sure that if not 6-7 billion, I'm thinking $3-4 billion will, inshallah.
Well, at least, of course.
Inshallah, will come in. And as Imran Khan has yesterday requested overseas Pakistani, okay, the dividend, your profit, you get it out of these certificate, please take it in Pakistani rupees.
I think
it's a very good gesture.
Definitely, great.
Yeah, because so the foreign exchange which we will bring to Pakistan should be available for Pakistan, but then the profit should go in Pakistani rupees. Although they have allowed in US dollar,
okay,
but he requested the overseas Pakistani, and I strongly endorse that, that the profit we should take it in Pakistani rupees. And that will be equivalent to the market rate, so it's no problem actually.
Right,
and Ms. Susan, the best part over here is that, you know, that the entire nation, you know, may it be overseas Pakistanis or people who live within Pakistan, I think that, you know, they're going to support Imran Khan's vision too as well. And ladies and gentlemen, this is indeed the way forward. But now, for all those overseas Pakistanis who are watching us right now, because we go out, we branch out in 46 different countries, what are the benefits they're going to reap out of these certificates? What kind of dividends are they going to get? Do we have any discussion on that?
Actually, you know, I lived in Scandinavia.
Yeah.
In Scandinavia, the interest is minus.
Okay.
If I put my money into the Sweden, Denmark, Finland, Norway, I have to pay money to keep my money.
Okay.
So, I mean, this is, for the Nordic Europe, it is absolutely superb that all the extra money you have it in the bank, you shift it to Pakistani banks.
Right, right.
So that is definitely there. And then on top of that, I don't think there is any bond available in US dollar, which is with 6.75% dividend, which is very, very good.
Is it annually, biannually?
Yeah, it's, and you know, I think they will pay biannually.
Okay. Hmm.
But the 6.7%, 75% is annual dividend for that, for these certificates.
Right.
So I think two things they have done very good, that the, you know, the denomination, they make it only $5,000.
Yeah.
Hmm. Minimum, so people can go for $1 million, whatever they wanted to do it.
Exactly. Hmm.
But and they will get 6.75% if they put these bonds for 6 years, I think, or 5 years.
Right. So one thing, you know, just recently Pakistan sort of, you know, renovated the visa policies, and among the 50 countries that had visa-free entry into Pakistan, there were 10 European countries, and Lithuania was one of the 10 European countries, which is absolutely great to look at.
I think, you know, there is no embassy of Lithuania in Pakistan.
Right, you are the only representation
of
Lithuania.
And I am the only representative of the president of Lithuania in Pakistan.
You should take us one day.
So yes, we will. And I feel that there is a dividend which I have got it for all my work for
some couple of years
in that out of the 10 countries in Europe, Lithuania is one of those
them.
In the Nordic
It sort
Europe.
Of, you know, defines the relations between Pakistan and Lithuania for the future as well.
Yes.
So what does the future hold?
Well, actually, I have been a couple of time with your program in the morning explaining Lithuania. I think, although it's a small country, but there's a lot of things we can do with them.
Hmm.
Last week we have a delegation from Lithuania, and we are giving them the technology and the system on LNG terminal, which is put in Karachi now. So how to handle and operate that? Lithuanian delegation was here last week to do that. Actually, it is knowledge-based country.
Right, right,
it's
definitely.
Research and development-based country.
Exactly.
As I told you in before,
before the show
this morning, that we are a small country of 3 million people.
Right.
But we are highly educated nation, and that's why I think there's a lot of things Pakistan can do it.
Indeed.
You know,
indeed.
And that is what I was actually coming to since you mentioned. So towards the end, just to wrap it up, you have to explain this briefly. Lithuania happens to be, you know, less than 30 years old, and it has such great exports, you know, literacy rate as well, employment and whatnot. So Pakistan being
Social
a friend,
security,
what can we learn? National security as well. So what can we learn, you know, from Lithuania?
Actually, sometimes it's people say that it is easy to manage few people. So, but a country like Lithuania, who got the independence from Soviet Union only 28 years ago, are cross over $55 billion export with 3 million people.
Wow.
With 3 million people, they cross $55 billion. So you can see that their export is based on high tech.
Exactly.
Right.
Absolutely, scientific high-tech export.
Hmm.
That is what they are doing.
Exactly. And there's this one message as well, and I think I keep on reiterating upon this one as well, and that is that since we are an agriculture-based economy, so with that, we definitely need to look forward towards the advancements there. There's been advancements in the machineries, in the equipment and whatnot, and then the labor too, obviously, because machines are taking over and productions are increasing. So probably for, you know, buying one iPhone, I think we really need to trade like one truck of wheat as well, you know.
Absolutely.
So probably we need to work on that.
Absolutely.
But before wrapping this up, sir, one more thing, since you're an overseas Pakistani yourself, and while we were discussing, ladies and gentlemen, that, you know, overseas Pakistanis have always helped Pakistan whenever we've been in dire need as well. But other than that, you know, a lot of overseas Pakistanis have to say that, you know, whenever we come down to Pakistan, there's not much respect which has been given to them. Do you agree to this? If you do, what should be done about this?
I think, you know, it's very, very important question you have put in.
Thank you, sir.
You know, in the good old days when I I used to come and attend a couple of conferences in the previous government also, they used to say, please send money to Pakistan.
Yeah.
I said, money is not important. Try to take this brain which is being now experienced, fertile, and they have gained a lot of experience. Please get these people know how what these Pakistanis are. And I think Imran Khan government has realized that, that it is not only money, they are looking for overseas Pakistanis to come and contribute in the development of Pakistan.
Right.
So that's a positive thing. Coming back to this, you know, question you said, tourism, I think it is very important.
Very important
that it is not only that we have made the visa regime very easy and all that, we should make sure that at the airport we have people to tell them you are welcome to Pakistan.
Exactly.
Right.
You
that
have
counts,
to give
course.
A smile to them.
Of course.
You have to, and I'm not talking of overseas Pakistani, I'm now talking of the tourist also, including overseas Pakistani, that they should get this feeling of welcome in Pakistan.
Definitely.
Exactly.
And that's very important.
Right.
We should see that people, the tourists who will come, they should not suffer here.
Exactly.
Yeah.
You know, they should be looked after. They feel very happy that they have come to a country which they have missed for many, many years.
Amazing. Amazing that is. Thank you very much, sir, for being with us. It was lovely to have you.
And you so
since
very
we have to move on to another segment as well, so we'll have to cut it short. But thank you very much for being
thank
with us.
So much,
and
sir.
We'll definitely see you in Lithuania then, for once, whenever you're going to take us along.
Let me know when you want to go.
Definitely.
I will definitely.
I'll host you there.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. So, ladies and gentlemen, this was about Pakistan-Lithuania relations. And we're always short on time, so we're definitely moving out to a short break. You have something to say?
Yes. And before we do that, ladies and gentlemen, you know, I'd like to speak about all the good omens which are around us as well. And Pakistan, ladies and gentlemen, recently have actually moved up in a place where it was in the index of ease of business within Pakistan as well. So I think that this is a good omen for people who actually want to do businesses in Pakistan, because we're moving up, we are progressing, and that's how
and
we want to do it.
Yeah,
Pakistan,
just one
Zimbabwe.
Last thing,
yes,
definitely. And since we're learning from Lithuania, you know, Lithuania actually produces the most graduates in Europe every, you know, 1,000 people, which we need to learn from, of course, and we need to have exchange programs and university collaborations and whatnot. But on this note, we're headed out to a short break. Stay tuned to PTV World.
Good morning.
Thank you. Welcome back to World This Morning, ladies and gentlemen, with Shahzad Khan and the very energetic Shiza Hashmi today, early in the morning.
Well, you missed out on me.
Well, you're energetic as well, of course. I said Shahzad Khan. But I think it is only unfair that we wrap up the week with you guys without adding the music quotient to it.
Exactly.
So I think
ladies
this is
and gentlemen,
time.
Today we've actually picked up on Qawwali, and I've got a lot to share about Qawwali as well, because I think I'm one of those people who can relate to Qawwali. So Qawwali, ladies and gentlemen, came out from the word call. Call is an Arabic word, and the meaning is to say something as well. But whenever we talk about Qawwali, ladies and gentlemen, it's like in religious ecstasy, you know, where actually musicians,
the soul speaks.
Yeah, where actually musicians kind of deliver the Sufi messages with the musical performances as well. And quite a lot of times the subject revolves around your divine love, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And you know, these messages have a very stronger impact on you as well, where you have a religious connectivity with your creator. So we wanted these brothers to have actually joined us over here on this Friday. The sole reason was because it's Friday, and we have actually shared and we have shed light upon the importance of Friday too as well. So on a Friday, when you get this spiritual feeling, I think that it is not less than ecstasy. I think that's what it is for me. And for that particular reason, ladies and gentlemen, we've actually been joined by these amazing Qawwal brothers. They've been all over Pakistan. They've been representing Pakistan out across the borders too as well. Some fabulous jobs which they have done with their music too as well. I like their music. Some crazy videos which they are making these days. So on my right hand side, ladies and gentlemen, a very helpful gentleman. Because a few days ago, I was actually looking for a harmonium, and he was the guy who actually guided me that, you know, this is the one which you should buy. So on my right-hand side with the Bina Harmonium, ladies and gentlemen, we have actually been joined by Rahim Al-Qadri. Hello, assalamu alaikum. How are you?
Assalam. Thank you very much. Rahim Sultan Al-Qadri.
Rahim Sultan Al-Qadri, ladies and gentlemen. And alongside Rahim Sultan Al-Qadri, we have been joined by Javed Sultan Al-Qadri as well, is his brother. Hi, how are you? Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam.
Thank you very much for joining us. And last but not the least, we have actually been joined by Bilu Bhai as well. Bilu Bhai, thank you very much for joining us. He'll be on percussions or tabla. That's what it is. But let's get the conversation started where we left it last time as well.
Yeah, exactly.
What's new in the box?
There are a lot of things new in the box, but on the very main note, that's we are performing live.
Yes.
And as much as we can.
We are performing
at our spiritual master's place every 11th of the lunar month.
Exactly.
And after that, there are a lot of concerts. We've been to Iraq.
Wow.
And we performed there at the shrine of Hazrat Ali.
Yes.
Walali. And after that, we performed at
Sheikh
Abdul Qadir Jilani.
Yes.
Rahmatullah Ali. Because of whose blessings today we are here. And because that's our spiritual tree, and it comes to my master, Hazrat Bahapir Khwaja Kifayat Ali, Al-Maruf Bahapir Khwaja Qadir Ali Sultan Qadri. And from there, it goes to my grandmaster,
yes,
Hazrat Bahapir Khwaja Abdul Bari Pekram Sultan Ghazi. And from there, it goes to Sindh Ranipur Sharif.
Wow.
Hazrat Bapi Rafiq Shah Jilani.
Very nice.
And because of their blessings today, we are here.
That's great. But you know, every time, Rahim, you know, you're over here on the show, you always make sure that you mention all the names of all of your spiritual teachers as well. Why is it important? And I've seen a lot of Qawwals do that too as well. Is it in honor of that? Is it in respect of that? Or is it just that your love is so greater for all of these people that you just cannot forget them?
You can say all of these things.
All of these things together.
Okay. But first of all, as you say, today we are here.
Yes.
That's all because of them.
Wow.
So that's why it's necessary to mention all of these.
Amazing.
All of these great personalities.
So today, ladies and gentlemen, this was supposed to happen, but I think that without any further ado, we do not really want to get into conversation, but we definitely want to listen to a few Qawwalis by you.
Sure.
So let's get started. What are we getting started with?
We are starting with the Kalam-e-Hu. That is written by my grandmaster, Bapir Khwaja Abdul Bari, Pir Karim Sultan Ghazi, Sultan Al-Qadri. So let's start.
Bin murshid nara milda tod se chille kamavan ho ho noori amal अंदर बनन आमिल वल जहन्नम जावण हू हो
कामिल जय नजर चाबालण पत्रानु
हजरत बारे दिल होया बैतुल हजरत बारे दिल होया बैतुल हजरत बारे दिल होया बैतुल हजरत बारे शाबाज अंदर रूदे परवाज पावन हो दिल होया बैतुल हजरत बारे दिल होया बैतुल हजरत बारे शाबाज अंदर रूदे परवाज पावन हो कामिल मुर्शिद है नजर मिलाए रूह करे गर दाने हू परवाजा मारे मारे इश्क जलावे कर दीदार सुल्ताने कामिल करम कमाया जिन्नत कामिल करम कमाया जिन्नत कामिल करम कमाया हजरत बारे जिन्नत कामिल करम कमाया जिन्नत कामिल करम कमाया हजरत बारे जिन्नत कामिल करम कमाया जिन्नत कामिल माया मिली अजमत दो जहाने हो जिन्नत का मिला कर्म कमाया जिन्नत का मिला कर्म कमाया मिली अजमत दो जहाने हो जिन्नत का मिला कर्म कमाया जिन्नत अजमत दो जहाने हो
So mesmerizing.
Yeah, it was indeed a very spiritual experience. But with that, there's a piece of information which I would like to share with all those people. See, so you know, the energies, they devolve. The energies change when you listen to Qawwali. I mean, this is not how we were talking or speaking earlier. But other than that, ladies and gentlemen, I want to share the concept of who. You know, so when we talk about who is actually that we are actually calling upon Allah in the first place, that's what it is. And it the only reason that we call him by this name is so that there's no gender attributed to Allah as well. You know, so this is one thing which everybody needs to realize. We're calling for him, and you know, and everybody does as Muslims too as well. And then he listens to our prayers. So this is the concept of who. But now moving on. So what kind of music will definitely be witnessing by Qadri Brothers in days to come? You know, what kind of qawwalis are you working on these days? What kind of new musical or qawwali videos are you working on?
Okay. And is there also a blend of probably contemporary music with the qawwalis that you're
exactly.
producing?
This is what we do. It's exactly, it is the studio, so we can't do all that kind of fusion in
right,
that.
Right.
But basically the concept is that reviving the era of that basic traditional qawwali by mixing it with, you know, the fusionized and a little bit, you can say, like a pop rock qawwali. But basically our motive is to do as much as live, because you know the live performances makes the most of its impact.
Definitely,
you can't
definitely.
Do that in recorded or in while you are lip sync on the stage. So you can't do that things. Exactly.
We truly agree to that. But you know, for that, you know, for example, you know, when we talk about qawwali, so qawwali's got a very different feel to it. You know.
Exactly.
Okay, so if somebody's going to ask me qawwali, I'll be like harmonium. You know, if somebody's going to ask me qawwali, I'll be like tabla. If somebody's going because you know when we talk about pop rock, I think that the real essence of qawwali diminishes in between because you know the guitars are too loud or something is just off. So do you think that these fusions will actually work? Because these fusions have worked for Raat Fateh Ali Khan Saab as well, Nusrat Fateh Ali Khan Saab as well.
Exactly. You know what, you couldn't follow what I was about to say.
Sure.
You know what I said that basic traditional era of qawwali, you know, so basically the instruments will be the same.
Okay.
Now we've got the percussionist, the way he plays, and we have got some other musicians that who play this, and especially when it comes to us, both of us. So when we sing, so basically we are doing this with the same instruments by adding a little bit of others, but especially basically we have these instruments.
Okay.
And what we are going to do is we are going to mix our own style in this with these instruments, with the same instruments of traditional qawwali. So when it comes to qawwali, and that comes to your mind, that harmonium and tabla. So basically these are going to be the main instruments, the necessary instruments.
I think that's great. But I want to move on to Javed Saab over
here.
So Javed Saab, you know, since all of you are brothers in the band too as well.
Exactly.
So there's this one thing which I want to ask, and that is that, you know, since I have a younger brother too as well, and we do not, you know, we are good friends, but, you know, at times there are difference of opinion too as well.
Exactly.
So while you guys are performing, or while you guys are working on a tune or a rhythm, you know, do we actually get to see a conflict in between brothers too as well? Nahi yaar, isko ye nahi karo, isko G kar lo, isko A kar lo, isko A minor kar lo. Something of that sort. Ki hum yahan se acha chal sakte hain. Kya aisa hota hai?
True. Aisa hi hota hai.
It does happen.
It really happens. It really happens.
I'll interrupt, sorry. But while doing this kind of things, we basically come to something really amazing.
Even better.
Yeah.
Something even better.
Yes,
right.
Exactly.
And this is why that, you know, the whole reason why I actually asked you this question is that that's how we're going to wrap up the segment. So lately, whatever you've come up with and is brilliant, please share it with us.
Thank you.
So it's a qawwali of, an old qawwali, it's an ancient qawwali. Ho karam ki nazar.
Exactly.
ہو کرم کی نظر عشق کے تاجور ہو کرم کی نظر عشق کے تاجور خواجہ خواجگاں خواجہ ہند الولی ہو کرم کی نظر عشق کے تاجور ہو خواجگاں خواجہ ہند الولی ہو کرم کی نظر عشق کے تاجور ہو کرم کی نظر خواجہ خواجگاں خواجہ ہے دل ولی خواجہ خواجگاں خواجہ ہے دل ولی سید الاولیاء نائب مصطفیٰ سید الاولیاء نائب مصطفیٰ قبلہ عاشقاں خواجہ ہے دل ولی سید الاولیاء نائب مصطفیٰ قبلہ عاشقاں خواجہ دل ولی سب کا تو آسرا ہم ہے تیرے گدا سب کا تو آسرا ہم ہے تیرے گدا سب کا سب کا تو آسرا
آسرا سب کا تو آسرا آسرا
سب کا تو آسرا ہم ہے تیرے گدا سب کا تو آسرا ہم ہے تیرے گدا ہم کو خیرات دے صدقہ مصطفیٰ ہم کو خیرات دے صدقہ مصطفیٰ تو عطا ہے عطا ہم خطا ہے خطا تو عطا ہے عطا
ہم خطا ہے خطا
تو کہاں ہم کہاں خواجہ ہند الولی تو عطا ہے عطا ہم خطا ہے عطا تو عطا ہے عطا ہم خطا ہے خطا تو کہاں ہم کہاں خواجہ ہند الولی ہم خطا ہے خطا تو کہاں ہم کہاں
خواجہ دل ولی
تو دلیل ولایت کی تن
Welcome back to World This Morning, ladies and gentlemen. Before this segment that we've just started, we sort of rejuvenated your soul. And it's now time we take care of your, you know, body. Physical health as well, yes. Your body as well, because we love to share everything good with you early in the morning.
Exactly, which is why today, ladies and gentlemen, our lifestyle coach has actually picked up on coconuts. And there's one thing which I know, coconut water is good for hydration.
Yes.
But over to Lubna. Hi, Lubna, how are you?
I'm good. Good morning to everyone. Happy Friday and Jumma Mubarak. I hope everybody has a great weekend. But before you do that, I want to tell you about my super favorite superfood in the world right now. And I get a lot of questions, just like you said, coconut water is great. It is. But I get a lot of questions about coconut oil. That is it good for your health or is it bad for your health? There's so much saturated fat in there. Is it bad for you or is it actually something that's the next biggest superfood? So I'm going to be sitting here in front of you today and I'm going to confirm that coconut oil or coconut in any form basically is an excellent source of fats, an excellent source of good nutrition for your body. And you totally need this and you should be adding this in your diet almost every single day. So I'm going to be talking about 8 medically proven benefits of coconut or coconut oil today and why you should have this every day in your diet. So let's get right to it. Number one is obviously everybody's favorite, which is fat loss. Now, how does coconut oil do this? Well, 92% of coconut oil is medium chain fatty acids. And the thing about the medium chain fatty acids is that it's absorbed by the body and used by the body much differently than any other dietary fat. So basically what happens is that it's absorbed right away and used as energy. So if you have it in the morning, say 1 tablespoon or anything, it's used right away as energy. If you're working out or if you're moving out and about for your day, it's used right away. It does not get stored in your body, so which is awesome news. And if you do consume coconut oil, within 1 to 3 months, you should see a huge difference in your fat loss. Number two that I want to talk about is obviously brain health. If you notice, a lot of doctors now are prescribing coconut oil for anybody who has symptoms of Alzheimer's or any kind of dementia. So basically, coconut oil is known to reverse these effects, if anything, and prevent the symptoms of Alzheimer's as well. So if you want to boost your brain health, you want to have some fat loss, use coconut oil on a daily basis. Thirdly, it heals wounds fast. Now, I know I've mentioned about aloe vera when I spoke of it this week, sometimes that is really good for you when you're trying to, you know, have make your wounds go better. But if you combine aloe vera with coconut oil and apply it on any kind of cut or scrapes, it will heal the wound so much faster because coconut has this property that boosts the collagen production of your skin. So any kind of cut or scrape will heal super fast. So you do want to use coconut oil and keep it very handy in your house. The next thing is that it's antifungal and antibacterial. There was a recent study done where they had 52 species of bad bacteria and they applied drops of coconut oil on it. And little do you know, it reduced literally 50 to all of them by like 90% or so. So if you have anything like yeast or any kind of bad bacteria in your stomach or any acids you're feeling, you should have coconut oil on your food or anything like that. And you will notice a huge difference in the cleanliness of your body. So coconut oil is great for that as well. After that, it will also balance your hormones, which is always good news because we are so stressed out these days, especially men. If you're looking for a boost of testosterone, coconut oil is really, really good for that as well. It will make you look healthier, better, more leaner. So you want to use coconut oil for that as well. And then again, heart health. I'm always talking about heart disease and cholesterol. So HDL levels will definitely go up by coconut oil. You want to be using this if you are a heart patient or if you have heart health history in your family as well. And other than that, nutrient absorption. You know, a lot of us now are taking vitamin D capsules or vitamin C and trying to, you know, make sure that we absorb all these amazing vitamins. All these fat soluble vitamins are absorbed much better if you have coconut oil in your diet because coconut oil binds with it and helps your body absorb them and use the maximum benefits from them. So you definitely want to do that. Last but not least, coconut oil has medically been proven to increase your bone health. So if you are somebody who has a lot of physical activity or you have any kind of, you know, bone issues, you want to use coconut oil because it will boost the collagen production in your bones as well and make them much, much stronger. So those were my 8 reasons. Here's the way I use coconut in my diet. I try to make my smoothies with coconut water, add a tablespoon of coconut oil in my smoothies or anything like that. If I'm going to be sauteing my vegetables or making my omelet in the morning, I try to use coconut oil for that. If you're going to be drinking water, you want to try and have coconut water because it's, like Jada said, like great for hydration and everything. So you want to use coconut oil every day in your diet.
And I remember just yesterday when you made a turmeric latte,
yes,
it was made
yes.
of coconut milk
exactly.
as well.
Exactly, so coconut milk, another great source.
Thank you so much. This was Lubna taking care of your health more than you guys are actually. I feel like. So towards the end, ladies and gentlemen, if there's anything you need to ask us or our nutritionist Lubna, write to us on our Facebook page. Which
has been the name of World This Morning.
On Twitter.
World This Morning without G.
Daily Motion on YouTube.
World This Morning, World This Morning.
And the repeat is going to be
5 past 11 p.m. tonight. Till the next time, 1, 2, 3.
Good morning.
Thank you.